Hello everybody! Welcome to my trivia channel here in sweltering Yorktown, Virginia, 97 today, the hottest day of the year. Wednesday, June 26, 2024. I'm not going outside again until September of 2024. This is true. You're not going to believe this. There really is a Gilligan's Island sequel. Well, I'll use that word. I put that in quotes, sequel. I think a remake or a reworking would be better because it's not really a true sequel, but it's called Dusty's Trail. Get it? Play on words, Dusty Trails. And it was made in 1976. Now, Gilligan's Island, you might remember, was mid-60s, like 64, 66. But Dusty's Trail was 73 to 74. Then the movie was 76. They made a movie out of some of the episodes called The Wackiest Wagon in the West. I'm serious. You can find this on YouTube. You're going, yeah, right, John? No, this is real. And TV Guide, critics hate it, but I love it. I don't care. TV Guide said, unless you're a big Gilligan's Island fan, there's nothing to see here. I'm all in. I got all my chips in the middle. It's made by the same gentleman that made Gilligan's Island and the Brady Bunch. So, you know, I'm 61, born in 1963. So we love all that stuff. You know, the Partridge Family, too, and all that. So, but it's so funny because Gilligan's Island made it 3 seasons, 98 episodes. Dusty's Trail made it 1 full season, 26 episodes. Not bad. They gave it a full year for as bad as the reviews were. But for the movie, what they did a couple years later is they packaged it as The Wackiest Wagon in the West. And they took episodes 1, 2, 3, and 8 and put them in a movie, but showed them in reverse order. 8, 3, 2, 1. Why, I don't know. It was kind of confusing, I guess, to make you think it was something new. Took me a while to figure it out. Oh, by the way, today's trivia question. This is a trivia channel. What was John? What was Bob Denver's middle name? A, John, like Bob, John Denver. B, Osborne, like the Ozzy Osbourne, Bob Osborne Denver. C, Gilligan. Yeah, his middle name was actually Gilligan. Bob Gilligan Denver. D, Bob Denver was too cool for a middle name. So, by the way, Bob Denver, an all-around talented guy. You know, you think of him doing that physical comedy. When he graduated from college, he taught at an elementary school gym, mathematics, and history. Talk about three diverse subjects. So he was a pretty talented guy. And in this Dusty's Trail, instead of Skipper, there's a guy named Forrest Tucker. And that's the one part of the show I think you might like. Forrest Tucker's even bigger than Skipper, Alan Hale. He was about 6'2". Forrest Tucker's like 6'4", 6'5", and big and burly as well. A huge man. So aside Gilligan, who's, I think, 5'8", 150. You know, he's smaller than me. I was 5'10", 180 in my adult life. Now that I'm older, I'm 5'9". I've shrunk an inch. I've lost 35 pounds. I'm 145. So, Forrest Tucker was like an old school actor, you know, did everything, vaudeville and everything. And he's not really normally a comedy actor, but it really works together, those two together. So that part I like. The two girls that played the Marianne and Ginger roles, you might recognize from Petticoat Junction. And one of them, the blonde, also from Hee Haw. Yeah, she did blonde this time instead of redhead. They didn't do the redhead with Ginger. And the Howells couple, there's a couple that you obviously are Mr. and Mrs. Howe. You'll recognize that instantly. That part, you go, wait a minute, where do I know those two? And then the professor guy takes a while to catch on. But once you realize other characters, then you go, well, he's obviously the professor, right? So, but the show also not politically correct. You know, this was made in the 70s. So it kind of, you know, you might get, if you get offended easy, maybe you don't want to watch it. Because, you know, it's different. You know, back then we grew up with All in the Family and the Jeffersons and everything. Anything went, you know. Richard Pryor, George Carlin. So very different than today's, where, you know, people don't want to get offended as much. But that's the 70s, they tried to offend you. You know, it was just a different world. I called this 1970s the Wild West of words, because it was a wild time to grow up. But yes, there is a sequel to Gilligan's Island set in the Old West. And like I said, you can find some of these episodes right on YouTube. For free, you got to check it out. And the wackiest—I watched the Wackiest Wagon in the West Is it the Wackiest Wagon or the Wackiest Train Wagon in the West? I watched it a couple Sundays ago. It was fun. It's 90 minutes, huh? Of your time. You get a kick out of it. Well, anyway, that's it. Oh, today's trivia question is B. Osborne. Bob Osborne, Denver. You didn't think it was going to really be Gilligan, did you? That would be cool. But, yeah, Bob Osborne, Gilligan. Well, that's it. And we'll see you for the next video. And here's my little... Too hot today to go out, huh? Can you say hello? Mr. Banks, name for the Outer Banks. Where's Finn? Where's your Uncle Finn? Name for Huckleberry Finn. He's just lying. It's too hot. Just dark colored boxers. You know, that dark fur on a sunny day, not a good combination. You know, they get the heat. Look at those cute paws. Can you say goodbye? Can you say woof? Can you say woof? Okay. See you in the next video. Bye.